think I'm live. Okay. Let's see, is it live on my channel though? That's a good question. Ah, there we go. It's still loading for me. Oh, okay. So for the past, like, I don't know, year, they've been working on the new Fire Ant update, which is finally here, so we're going to click OK. And we got to rehouse the colony, which... Okay, well, I'm just using a colony where I'd officially beaten, like, everything
before.
Is it done?
Yes, yes. Look. Gone.
I see. Well, good. It's about time. Anyway,
all of our ants are dead.
I'm going to need you to make yourself available this afternoon. Apparently a large quantity of unrefined jelly has gone missing from the overflow vessel, and Supply wants to speak with the whole group about proper checkout procedures. You wouldn't happen to know anything about it, would you?
What? No! What would I want with unrefined jelly?
Well, quite.
What would I want, indeed?
Alright, so let's upgrade these ants. Let's see, we got... Oh, okay, well, people are in my chat. Bro, you play the weirdest games. Hey, this is a fun game. Hello, Zero Exact Gaming. You are awesome. Sword 4000, on the other hand, is always randomly in my... Look, man, this is an ant game. You get to play as ants. I'll show you guys once I finish figuring out what I want to set up. Fire and attack damage is increased when they're mounted on an enemy. So, oh. I think we want to go for full damage with fire ants. Because they have... Little health anyway. It's an ant game, Zord. I already said that. Upon death. I think we're just gonna go full damage output on these guys. Alright. So, what we are going to do is we are going to do the 4-1 cold blood. We're gonna do it on easy because I don't know. Yeah, I did pay money for it. It's a great game. I was here for the beta testing. We are going to start this level. No way. Yes, it's an ant game. Look at these guys. So the new mechanics that they've come out with. Alright. Here we go.
Selenopsis Invicta Fire Ant Queen has landed on the edge of a swamp. She may be far from her native habitat, but the fire ants are well known for their ability to adapt. Competition for food will be fierce. She will need to raise an army quickly to compete with the local predators.
Alrighty, so we got a lot of food here for now. So we're gonna go and put our food tiles around. Alright guys, can you pick up the food or something? Yeah, all right there. Come on, grab it. No. What are you guys doing? Ooh, we got two new icons. Aphid relocation and mounting. All right, so that's one of the new mechanics.
The colony lies in the shadow of a great titan to the north.
Oh. Oh my goodness gracious.
Large female has found the
I have to fight a frog? How do I fight a frog? I've got little ants! Oh no!
Eventually she will need to be displaced. But for now, the fire ants have more pressing business to attend to.
Can you give ants guns? No, it's not an American ant colony, unfortunately. So these are food stores here. This is where you can put all your food, which is seen up here. This is your capacity to carry food. You have pheromone markers. So say, for example, if I build up some army ants here really quick. Let's go ahead and do that. So you got workers, which they cost 20 food to place and 2 food to hatch. They have less health compared to the fire ant warriors. So we're going to place a whole bunch of those right here.
The boggy soil surrounding the nest is lacking in nitrogen and phosphorus, nutrients vital for plants to photosynthesize and grow. To survive in this environment...
And then they take eggs from the queen here and bring it over and place it on the brood chambers, and the ants grow. Ah, screw it, we can just remove that. If you see down in the map here, there are 3 icons, meaning that there are 2 other ant nests. There's one, there's the other one. And so, when I get close enough, and my fire ants get close enough, we can go in and attack a nest, which will be pretty fun to see happen. So, now that I have a decent-sized army, I can drag them over and put them under pheromone marker number 1. And if I place it down, as you can see, the ants that are in that subsection will all gather on it. So, why don't we get a few more food going on?
Predators are loose in the nest.
So,
the larvae must be
that's a new enemy. Oh, fire ants are absolutely destructive.
The hungry checkered beetle larvae. The soft grubs may look defenseless, but they have big jaws and appetites to match.
Alright. So with fire ants, I think that the best way to go is literally just to mass produce them. Because one of the new mechanics is to go across water.
A small colony of Fadelay Morisi big-headed ants have established themselves on a hill to the west.
Oh, wait, let's not go that way.
For seeds, aphids, and dead insects, they
whoa,
they got a
spider. Interesting. It says there's something big here. Oh, there's a spider on a pitcher plant. That's interesting. 2 spiders on pitcher plants. Look at all these little green spiders. So fun. And there's the checkered beetle is this one. Alright, let's keep gathering food for right now. I was just having fun looking around. Just gonna get a ton more warriors. Get them! Mess them up, warriors! Yeah, look at these guys. I don't know why they have glow bug butts, but. Alright. Well, that's a ton of food. We're gonna need a bigger army ant chamber. I think we can start to put some workers to help out with caring for the brood. Since workers are required to take the brood from the queen to each of these chambers. You can also upgrade ants and such. I was doing it to the food stores here. That gives a better capacity. These guys, when I think they're 2-3, I think they can have... I don't know how much it costs. I bought it during the beta, so it was pretty cheap, like $25 for me. And then, I don't know if they've increased the price since then. But it's actually pretty fun to play sometimes, if I ever get bored. I wanna... let's go fight whatever this is. Alright, you workers, we're gonna keep you in here. We're gonna put you on don't defend. But you guys can pick up food. So I like to put my workers on don't defend. Because that means if something like, I don't know, as we break through here, if we open up into an enemy, they just don't attack it. Wow, fire ants are incredibly powerful. They just decimated these guys. Ant Simulator 2021. Yeah, pretty much. We're gonna go this way. 19 soldiers. Oh, we ran into some enemies. Yeah, see, our ants are pretty... The fire ants are pretty weak, but they deal high amounts of damage. And they sting, which I think does even more damage. Actually, maybe we get some upgrades going on here. Is there anything over here? There's gotta be like an enemy right there or something. Let's get you guys. It's gotta be something here. I guarantee it. Nerd. Thank you, Trojan. This is the greatest game ever made. I think so too. So now we have some tier 2 fire ants. We need a tier 3? Alright, let's see what a tier 3 can do.
Even small numbers the fire ants are menacing, but in large numbers, they are virtually unstoppable.
So, it looks like tier 3 housing can hold 2 ants on one, and they both end up as level 3s. Level 3s are much larger than the other ants. As you can see, you got your tier 1s, kind of small, and then they scale up with size to tier 3s. Get them, boys. So you can see that Sting did like half of its health. So it appears that Sting is a very powerful attack, but then they go back to normal biting. Is he thick? Yeah, he is. We're gonna continue to mass produce warriors for right now. Where do we want to go here? I think we're gonna go down here. You can go outside if you want, but I think I'm gonna clear out the entire lower area. Eliminate the bullfrog threat. We're gonna have to fight a frog, guys, eventually. Let's just make this all warrior habitat, honestly. We're just gonna mass produce these guys. Alright, there's some food there. Go ahead and pick that up. Is there anything else here? Is that it? Huh. We have to go this way now, I think. Yeah, let's just unleash everything. I think we have enough warriors to fight off anything that shows up. Become the warriors. Well, maybe let's wait on that one. So as you can see, they can only dig where tiles are connected. So if I leave this one unconnected, then they're not going to go, oh, hurdy-dur, I'm going to start breaking this. Otherwise, that'd go very poorly. I have 3 random pings, but I don't want to check my... Music is pretty good as well. Oh, there's the checkered beetle. It's no longer alive. It wasn't that dangerous. I obliterated it. Alright. So we got all our warriors back because we just slaughtered that guy. We have a bit more food to play around with. Maybe get these guys upgraded. Oh, that's a ton of food. All right. Let's spend our time collecting this. I'm gonna throw some of my workers to go help with that food collection. So even though that these guys are said not to defend, if I move them over to this tier where they are allowed to defend, they follow the pheromone marker. As you can see, they will do whatever the pheromone marker is set to do. So. This hides it, so they're just normal ants. If you want to play like this, this hides the food. I usually like to be able to see this. I don't like being able to see all the tile stuff, so I usually don't do that. Alright, let's get some more tier 3s going. Let's expand out just a little more. Okay, so now we have 4 tier 3. Fire ant soldiers. We are still collecting the food.
As the sun sets, the local amphibians begin to emerge from moist crevices near the water's edge. Lone invertebrates will be picked off quickly.
There was a salamander.
Should travel in numbers or not at all.
Oh, look at the salamander! Look at him go! He's destroying those ants. Look at that guy. This is all happening outside my nest. Wait, is this my nest? No, this is my nest. Okay. Alright, so we collected all the food. You guys can go back. Let's continue to get some more upgrades on these guys. I do like having the tier 3s that can hatch 2 at once. So I need less tile space for more ants. And they're tier 3, so I don't have to upgrade them all the way. Let's get 3 more tier 3s. Maybe 4 more.
A bombardier beetle, Brachinus altierans, is hunting for insects outside the nest. It may seem unwise for it to wander so freely amongst the large amphibians that share the swamp at night, but they would do well to leave it alone.
I don't see the bombardier beetle. I don't see it. I saw a salamander go on by. Toad arrival. What are you gonna do? What does it mean by toad arrival? Is the toad gonna like show up on top of my nest? Oh, I wanna watch this. Hi, Mr. Toad. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh! What? There's a toad. There's a toad breaking into my. What? There's a freaking toad burrowing in. Hey! What's he doing? Oh, guys, we gotta find a toad. I wasn't expecting to find a toad. He's breaking into my habitat. Hey, come here. Come here, Toad. Let's go. Where's he going? I don't know where this Toad is going. No. What do you mean, American Bullfrog? Oh! That poor Newt! He's got obliterated! Okay, what is this guy doing? Where are you gonna come from? That Newt just got eaten. Where's this toad going? He's just hanging out, I guess. Alright. Cool. So this is the toad area. We're just gonna dig this completely out. I wanna be ready for if he tries to break in. He's just... He's wiggling around in the earth out there. Where's he going? He's leaving. I'm gonna keep him situated right here. Ready to go if that toad shows up. Is he just going this way now? Alright. What is this guy doing? I want to fight him, boys, but he doesn't seem to want this smoke. He's right here. Come on in. No, he's going back. What? I'm ready for him. He's going down here now. Got all my warriors ready to mess him up if needed. Where are you going? Oh, could this be it? Is he gonna come through here? Nope, he's going back up. Alright. Oh, he's going this way. So maybe the fact that I'm ready to jump. Yeah, he's leaving again. Maybe if I'm just not ready to jump him. I think he doesn't want to be jumped. If I go somewhere else. Let's keep an eye on that little. He left! He. What?
Oh, there goes a salamander! Oh, look at it! The great bullfrog remains. She sits
patiently on her throne, waiting for the next. Yeah, I don't want to fight that. Alright, well, I think on this day, we can fully clear these out. I think I'm going to make a second group of fire ants, usually close to the queen. Probably, what's a good spot? Maybe this area up here. Let's gather up all that. Actually, you know what? No. You guys are going to go gather this while my fire ants are going to continue to attack something else, because I know there's no enemies up there, so those guys can go gather that. Well, you guys come on down here. Oh, look, an idiot. And it's dead.
Predators are loose in the nest.
No, they're not. I just killed it. Nope, it died. Just to make that even, somebody else doesn't kill me. Let's just get a few more upgrades over here. Just a few more tier 3s, because I love having more than one ant on each tile. Okay. Now what? Right. Let's get some more food. Going. I guess we can bring you guys down here. For those who don't understand why I love playing this game, is I used to play it way back in the day, like when it was first developed, and what ended up happening was I got bored of the game, and they start coming out with updates, and they're like showing all these pictures of the new stuff and such. And eventually the update came out. Okay, we have a ton of food now. We can definitely build a second little army. We're gonna put them up here. Alright, so eventually we're gonna go to the surface and attack things. Not sure if I want to attack other ant colonies right now. I guess I can stay there while they're gathering that food up. Alrighty, here comes all the food. Yeah, I can see it costs food for an ant to hatch off of these. Don't do it, surface sucks. Surface does suck. I don't want to go out there. I mean, look at that spider. It's a very large spider. And he's up on top of a pitcher plant now, which will be interesting to see how the ants deal with that. There's a little spider. Oh, what are you? Whoa. That looks like a praying mantis of sort, like a floral praying mantis. It's got like the body of a wasp almost. That's terrifying. I don't want to fight that. But considering we're fire ants and we're invasive and we destroy everything in our way, we probably will have to fight that. Alright, so I think we've gathered all of the food from down here. We've got two separate armies. One doesn't have any upgraded, but they have far less than the other one. Let's get some of these guys upgraded, actually. I just want at least one tier 3 for these guys. Oh, it should be a tier 3. Yep, okay. What do we attack? Alright, we're going to send you guys to deal with that. Like Venus flytraps. I wanna fight that thing. Oh. Looks like those guys got into a battle. Where'd that spider go? Let's see how the Venus flytrap works. Uh-oh, first spider encounter. That first spider got annihilated.
Jumping spider.
Oh my gosh.
Alright.
Can you die to these?
To be spotted by predators and prey alike. Out on the ground, it's more vulnerable.
No! Don't go into the... No! No! No, you fools! Ah, so the Venus flytrap does eat them. Alright, so I kind of want to go see what this does. I know it's unwise and we're always getting ambushed and obliterated, but it's whatever. Oh wait, here's the new mechanic. Alright, so guys, the new mechanic is...
A wasp mantid fly, Kumachala Brunea, has descended from her perch into the path of the ants. Unrelated to true mantids, her spiked raptorial forelegs are a perfect example of convergent evolution.
Oh, so these just kill you. You don't get any food from them. Alright. So this is a new mechanic. They can form a bridge out of their own bodies on water. Ooh, a pine cone. Oh, I ran into a spider. That spider died. I didn't expect... Picking up the aphids. Okay, let's get a ton of food going here. Here comes my army. Alright, so as we begin the upgrades. Oh, I don't have enough food. Are we fighting a beetle? Yeah, sting it to death. Alright, it's dead. We've almost collected all 600 food here. So let's see. That wasp, where it just freaking flew down on top of me, that was terrifying. Let's look at the frog one more time. I don't know how I'm going to kill that. My ant is maybe the size of 1/5 of its toe. Alright, let's look for these aphids. I saw the positions on the map, but... Should we just attack another nation? Should we send it? There's a beetle, boys. Mess him up.
The ants must defend themselves.
Let's go here. A large spider up there that these guys might run into. Oh, they're picking up the aphids. Oh, so I can steal the aphids from them, I think. Makes sense. I didn't collect all that food, that's unfortunate. Alright, so let's get a few more tier 3s. Then we will amass our army and fight another nation. Now they're just controlled by AI. I'm not killing someone in real life. If, like, they were someone in real life, I would have been attacked by them now. Alright, so this is where we combine our two to be under one pheromone marker. I think we go from this way. Yeah! Dun 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 rather in. Where is that guy going? Alright, we go. We just finish him off. Sting him and kill him. Go. Go.
The fire ants have encountered a tribe of Monomoria Minimum black ants. These tiny little ants may seem feeble, but the Invicta colony would do well to treat them with caution.
No.
Although primarily scavengers, they are armed with powerful chemical secretions and have been known on occasion to invade fire ant nests.
Doesn't matter.
Once
too powerful.
Dusk sets in over the swamp.
Dusk is setting. That's not good. Get the queen. Kill it. Kill the queen. Go, go, go.
The Monomoria Minimum colony is almost defeated. The Invicta army must press their
We killed
advantage.
It. Alright, now all their tiles turn into food.
The little black ants fought to the last to defend their queen.
Salamander!
The colony will enjoy the
spoils
of war.
Hey, wait, is that salamander coming for me?
From the vanquished colony will be carried home and fed to
the hey, guys, we got a salamander! Hold on, boys. Sting it. Ah, we got it.
Crevices in search of food.
Killed a salamander. Alright, so we killed our first other team. I think I want to kill every single one, just because that's going to be like one of my other main goals. I mean, the main goal is kill the bullfrog. Toad arrival. Oh, there's another salamander that just got eaten as he was trying to fight her. Oh, right, toad arrival. That means he's coming into my nest. I'm gonna make actually a little scavenger nation where they're gonna go and pick up food while my warriors are fighting elsewhere. Everyone come back. Bring back the spoils. Ah! It's over here now. Maybe the toad doesn't burrow if my fire ants are too close. Because like that wouldn't make sense for him. He'd walk right into a trap. So we're just gonna pull back a little and let him do whatever he wants. Set these guys to don't defend. Oh, there's two frogs. Gonna let these frogs try and invade our nest. I wanna see them invade, because I wanna kill frogs. Not that bullfrog though. That bullfrog looks like he's gonna mess me up. Oh no! That's a massive spider.
The ants have set upon a green-winged spider, Putchetcha viridans. She prefers to hunt and pitcher plants, but out in the open, she loses her advantage. Far from defenseless, however, when threatened, she can spit venom up to 30 centimeters.
Jeez. Alright, guys, don't go near that. Where are these frogs? I was ready to fight frogs, but they don't seem to want to fight me. Nest. Oh, what happened? Oh, they left with the food. I thought I was getting like attacked by the bullfrog or something. Alright, Go get more food.
The colony is starving.
I know.
Enough food to feed the new brood.
Those are a lot of tier 3s. They have a massive army on that nation. Let's bring back food and maybe we can go attack another colony. Well, I kinda wanna fight that Lynx spider, but I guess we can send some boys out to beat the bombardiers. Look at that boy. What's marked here? Oh, I want to go gather that. These are the aphids.
For the swamp amphibians, the nighttime feast is over. Toads give way to tiger beetles, and the ant colonies step up their activities. If the fire ants are to stand any chance of establishing a long-lasting empire, they must grow quickly. There is no time to waste.
Let's go steal their aphids. So it looks like the yellow number is the amount of aphids, and then the white is the amount of food that they have produced. Actually, wait. I should probably go and keep these guys focused on our aphids. Then we steal the aphids from the other colonies. How many aphids have we gathered? Grab them. Let's grab all these guys and then send the rest to grab those aphids because we've got to cross a water ridge. Could you imagine if a nuke came down and just like blasted my ants as I was crossing?
The ants must fight.
Oh, there was the wasp thing. Ugh. Glad I sent my army instead of my normal ones over. Alright, so we've stolen their aphids. The stealing of aphids begins. I think that one has an aphid.
Defenseless caterpillars exposed on the underside of leaves are a welcome snack for the passing fire ants.
Oh! You
should take advantage while it can. Few meals surrender so willingly.
I see. That spider died. Ah, I hate that thing. Don't like wasps. Got a little bridge of fire ants here. Alright, let's go. Ooh, more spiders like to drop in front of my guys. And we'll attack this other guy's nation. We amass troops on the border right now. Well, these guys go kill all these caterpillars. I mean, we'll die to these guys, but they're like, ooh. I don't think these guys reset.
A curious ant has ventured onto a Venus flytrap in search of nectar.
If we did not find nectar.
The hairs on the open red-tinged leaves, they will snap shut.
Yeah, I learned that the hard way. Yeah, he did die.
The prisoner will be slowly digested until nothing more than a husk.
It was very sad. Alright, so how many... Yeah, we have 36 aphids. We're gonna need more workers to collect that.
Aimless parasitic wasp, Dazimutilla ochidentalis.
What the f-
More commonly known as the red velvet ant, has wandered into Invicta territory.
Oh my gosh!
If not on the hunt for fire ants, it will defend itself if threatened, armed with an extremely powerful sting.
Oh my gosh!
Displaying bright warning stripes, most creatures give it a wide berth.
Dude, did you see that stinger? That's terrifying. I don't want that thing to fight me. Let's just make these all workers. That can collect the aphids for us. I'm gonna make another little one that'll help out with. These guys shouldn't attack anyone. They'll help out with just the nest activities. Mollet. Alright, we're gonna combine into one group now. You know what? Let's fight the spider. Yeah, what could go wrong? Oh. You know, maybe we don't fight the spider. We are taking heavy casualties. Alright, spider, not fun. Let's go this way. Let's fight the other colony. Onwards to their nest.
The fire ants and big headed ants have met in their first skirmish. Sensing the new danger, the Morisi colony responds by awakening ancestral super soldier genes in selected brood, feeding them until their heads are engorged with muscle.
That doesn't sound great. Let's kill them before that happens. Oh, there's a first big-headed.
The big-headed ants now have a super soldier caste to justify their name. At huge economic
Where's the queen?
Cost to the colony, these frenzied champions have been raised for one purpose: to crush the fire ants.
Oh yeah, look at that thing. That has a lot of health. Doesn't matter if fire ants sting. Get him. Get to the queen. No, don't go that way. Okay, I guess those guys can go distract those guys while these guys come up here. What's going on down here? We have a few keeping them from going anywhere else. We are almost to the queen. Yeah, sting the queen. Yeah! Now we got it.
The Morisi colony has fallen. Their champions spent and their queen vanquished.
Nice. Of course they couldn't. We're amazing. We're still gaining tons of sap from the aphids. Oh right, we want to gather some aphids. Bring those back. That's a big spider. That's another big spider. Is it gonna wander into our lines? Well, you watch that? It shot the.
The ants will fight to the death.
Oh, we need to pick up that aphid. Someone grab it. No, grab the aphid. Someone grab that aphid, please.
An ant has fallen victim to a carnivorous plant.
No! Don't wander into there. That's whatever. Food stores are full. Man, we are making too much food. Upgrade the army. We don't have any more to upgrade, so larger army.
Fight to the death.
I don't know what we're fighting, but it's whatever. Whatever it is, I made the unfortunate mistake of wandering into fire ant territory. Alright, we gathered the aphids. Cool. Cool. And I guess that means we bring these guys in here to help gather these food. We're continuing to gain more and more food. I want to fight that spider. But it doesn't want to come down. We have so many aphids. Oh yeah, you probably want to stay on there. The amount of brood we have. It's time to attack the bullfrog. Let's get some food reserves up. Hello, game looks fun. Is the audio very low or is it just me? My audio's pretty low. I was trying to cut out the static that my mic randomly decides to produce, but I couldn't figure out how to do that. So I just turned everything down to the point where you can't hear the audio. It's whatever. So if I turn it up, you can hear the static even worse. Which I don't want people to hear, so I just turn it down. I can turn up the other audio though. Alright, that's the final upgrade. After that, we're going to attack the bullfrog. Let's grab a little
night
bit more
approaches,
food. Okay,
and
maybe we don't.
The predators of the day give way to their nocturnal counterparts.
Alright, maybe we fight things
as
on.
As they encroach on colony territory, battles must be chosen wisely. Spread too thin, the fire ants could find themselves quickly overwhelmed.
I agree. Maybe we focus on trying to fight that frog that, like, comes through here. Maybe, yeah, screw it. Attack the bullfrog. Go. Go, my army. Destroy it. I swear it can't hurt you. Oh, that guy got eaten.
Mounted their first attack upon the great American bullfrog, Litabate Scatesbianus. The brave frontline soldiers are quickly crushed and eaten.
Yeah.
They must surround and swarm the enormous creature to
get
stand
it.
Any chance of defeating it.
Why is there a bombardier beetle coming? I don't want to fight you. I'm busy fighting a frog!
A false bombardier beetle, Gallerita bicola, is also on the prowl for small prey tonight. It impersonates the true bombardier to ward off potential predators.
Well,
and its mimicry isn't simply visual. It too can spray defensively from its abdomen. In this case, the fluid of choice is the familiar formic acid.
We're gonna kill the frog!
Again and again, soldiers clamp onto the bullfrog's leathery skin and inject their Solenopsis venom, but the beast shows no signs of
We got it!
The fire ants must maintain their resolve.
We killed the frog.
Overwhelmed with burning venom, the bullfrog finally succumbs to the might of the fire ants.
Yeah!
Utterly spent, it collapses on the hillside, leaving the victors free to consume its body.
Yeah, eat the frog.
Unbeknownst to the ants, the presence of the bullfrog was keeping many other local amphibians at bay.
What do you mean?
The power vacuum it left behind is attracting a host of salamanders and frogs eager to take its place. The ants should go to ground quickly and prepare for the imminent chaos.
Oh, what do you mean? I thought the frog was the end. What do you mean the frog's not the end? Oh, boys, get down. Hide. What do you mean? I thought killing the bullfrog was the win. Screw it. Soldiers, make more. Hundreds, thousands of fire ants. We have enough food to do it. They can't stop us if we're just completely made out of soldiers. Huh? Hey. Get out of my nest. Look at all these salamanders. Oh, frog. No, it's a salamander. Salamander made it into the nest. What is he doing? Get out of my nest. Alright, that'll be my attack squad. The rest of you stay on the queen. Oh boy, here it goes. Oh boy. Get the nuke. Yeah. Get that one. Alright, we need someone to go take care of that one. This is pure chaos. There's newts. That newt is about to get a welcoming. Goodbye, newts. Chose the wrong fire ant nest. Protect the brood. Fall back. Goodbye, newt. Me and Nair. Get it. Get these newts. Yeah. That one just walked right in. What's a frog? The frog! Look at this thing. I look at the frog. Aww. I wanted to see the frog, and I got to see the frog. Oh. He's eating my ants. Stop that. Die. Oh, we need our army to take care of that frog. Here come more salamanders. Mark that one. We don't have enough fighters over here. Maybe really quickly divert a little. Oh yeah, we need to divert a little. There's another frog. Get him. That one's next to our queen. That one needs to go. Killing the frogs. Okay.
As the anarchy above ground settles, and with the invaders crushed, a new order is established. This is now the domain of the Fire Ant.
Wow. That was a fun first. I thought killing the bullfrog would end the level, but suddenly got attacked. I mean, I guess it makes sense. Alright. We don't need royal jelly. We don't need territory. So let's end the level there. That was a good first level. We got our food and such. Let's go back to our house. Formicarium is like, the scientists are experimenting on it, and the it levels are just, you can play strong. Ants out elsewhere.
Will continue soon.
Hello?
Shh.
Oh, it's you. Is something wrong?
No.
A lot of food. What kind of ants do we get? So we have 5 different types of ants. So 4. So I guess we make north. Then we have the other directions. And then these will just grow and grow as we have more and more area to work with. Storage here, but we probably need food to make a food storage. Okay, go gather some food so we can get the other ants spawned in, because it looks like these guys are ready to hatch, we just don't have the food to hatch them. Oh, they're grubs. I can't even see the grub. Okay, there we go. Here come our ants. We'll just make this area completely workers. and then our 4 different soldiers, and then food stores and speed up tiles here for the other 2 soldiers that spawn back here. So we probably want our strongest defenders coming out of here, and then our highest attackers coming out of here. Probably put fire ants here and then black ants here. That sounds good to me. So we need to build some more of those guys. Finish digging out the areas I want to dig out. We have like 7,000 food, I think. Now it's just tree building. We build up our nation, because what ends up happening is this is a Formicarium challenge. It will unlock the next tier, which doesn't exist yet. I mean, we just got this tier. So. Oh, no. Ah. Have Ender Dragon at home, indeed. Stores are full. Because that means we need to make food stores. Excavate more. That's all right. Works for now. I think we'll do a 2 ring. We don't want to bottleneck our ants as they come out to defend if we ever like get pushed back into our own nest. So we'll do a ring of 2. All right. Let's start getting some of these guys up. Those will be our defenders. Those will be our attackers. These guys do the most damage. They're like ranged, basically, so they just spray acid on people. It's pretty fun, honestly. These guys are our heavy defenders. You'll see why in a second here. 150 food just to place them. Let's get some fire ants going over here. Still a lot of food to collect and work with.
Solenopsis invicta. Interesting presentation.
Look at that thing.
Fully functional stinger, too.
I'm talking about this guy right now.
What's marvelous?
Oh, my sandwich. Yes, it came with an unusually generous dab of fiery pepper sauce.
How many times have I told you? No food in the lab.
Yes, okay, fine, I'm going.
Look at this guy. Let's go find him. That's the smallest version of him, too. He's a leafcutter major. He is absolutely a beast. A force to be reckoned with. They have tons of health. The way I have them upgraded, they actually... I'll show you here. They actually help our ants, so anything nearby takes 30% damage as well. And all incoming damage is reduced as well. That one looks pretty fun, but I do like the resilient. Let's fill out our fire ants. And these are the normal black ants. This is what you started with. This is how the game started. It's just these guys. So, it was pretty fun to try and play. It's just only black ants. You just end up with massive armies of black ants that you would just send into things. So those are our four types. These guys will end up protecting the queen, etc. If you look here, these are my wood ants. The worker. So this colony is called a gene thief. We kind of steal the genes of everything else. So my gene thief queen, upon dropping down to 75% health, it restores the queen health back to full, and then becomes invincible for 30 seconds. And when I hit 75% health, all of the hatcheries just hatch. So it gives me a second win. Two is I like it so they can help out. Oh, my food stores are full. I should probably upgrade it, to be fair. Make some more efficient in the nursery and such. And I like it so that they don't get seen by enemies, so when they're trying to put the eggs back on our tiles, they have a chance to just not get seen, and they're just like, la-di-da-di-da, walk out in the middle of a war zone. Hey guys, how's it going? How's it hanging? Let's get those guys filled out. These guys get filled out. I think I'll have enough food to complete that full of the big boys. But you never know. Doing good at collecting all the food here. So that's enough to complete that. We're not going to upgrade any of them because we're probably going to do the 4.2 before we do anything else. Oh wait, no, I don't need to put it there. Ah, I'm an idiot. That's unfortunate. It's a very big waste. Now the army is pretty decently sized. We're all tier 1s, but it's built out pretty well. Thank you. these guys out. Man, look at the size of them compared to other ants. Like, look at that little tiny worker, and then you got this big boy coming through. I guess we can add the speed tiles. These just make it so whenever ants walk on them, they walk faster. I like to have them in narrow hallways like this so that these guys can get out faster. They also help with the food. So everything gets upgraded just by being near these guys. That's unfortunate. But as you'll see here, the ants go meow. But we don't have any ants to walk on them right now. They're all busy getting all this delicious food. Food stores are stocked pretty nicely now. I'd be an idiot to try and attempt the Gateway Challenge before doing 4.2. Gateway challenges are kind of scary, especially with what I've seen. They might have like large things, like I don't know, American bullfrog comes storming in through my area. What is that? The shovel. Ooh, you can see like documents outside. Empires of the Undergrowth. Aw, it's a book. Look at that. That's awesome. Interactive. I think that might be the company. Don't know. Once we kill that guy, we'll have collected all the food. So we can upgrade probably our DPS. Easy. It would have been funny to only do fire ants. Like, this entire thing is just fire ants. But, fortunately, I don't want to do that. I like having... You know what, maybe one of these times I'll end up doing that. It's just a challenge, is only to use fire ants to beat a gateway mission. Aw, look at those super soldiers. So as you can see, they speed up as they go across these tiles. Meow. Alright, I think we're gonna end the stream here. I'm gonna do a quick break, maybe put some more thunder or something, and then we're gonna come back probably today to do the second mission. Which I think I've played before. They had a bit of a demo to show off the fire ants, and I think this was one of the ones that they did. So we are going to save the Formicarium, and we're going to quit to main menu. So the one that we're doing is the story, but free play also has some uses. If you see free play, you can set up whatever you want. Environmental. I'd be terrifying if they added, like, an uber. Uber creatures are basically, like, the things have 10 times more health than the normal creature and does way more damage. Could you imagine an uber, like, American bullfrog? Like, you'd just get obliterated. He'd be like, alright, bet, let's go. Doesn't look like they've added the fire ant stuff here yet. Because the first... Oh, wait, no, they have. Okay. So they do not have, they don't have any uber of the swamp creatures, but these are the swamp creatures. You got the checkered beetle, checkered beetle larva, spotted tiger beetle, magnolia green jumper, wasp mantid fly, hate that thing, bombardier beetle, red velvet ant. An uber red velvet ant is probably the most interesting one. Narrowmouth frogs, pinewood tree frog, store salamander, okay. So it doesn't look like you can add the American bullfrog. It's probably just a level specific thing. But that's what free play is, and then they got other modes here. Got your extra levels. Hibernation was fun. I think I did that at one point. In the battle arena. This is basically where you can make creatures fight. Heck yeah. Whoa. Ho! Okay. I don't think it was made for the American bullfrog. He doesn't fit in here too well. Clash of Titans. Oh my goodness. Wasn't like this guy's been implemented as something to fight yet. What if we just introduce a whole bunch of these guys? Get them, fire ants. Swarm. Mess them up. Go. Jeez. That splash attack that he did was pretty cool. I just want to kill this to see if you can actually attack this dragonfly. Kill the American bullfrog. Yeah! We got it. Ooh. Oh my gosh, you can. It does not have much health, though. Oh, but it does have, like, landing attacks, it looks like. Cool. So it is implemented. That's probably what I'm going to end up fighting in the next level. Let's just get some red velvets to finish it off. Where'd you guys end up over here? Did they get... that's a bug. They get splashed attacked outside. So it looks like the American bullfrog can splash attack things outside to the other... Ha! It's hilarious. Now they're in the other lane. Oh. Let's do 50 of these guys. Against 50 of these guys. Who's gonna win? Gonna guess the salamanders, they're taking far too little losses. And that sting is lethal for the rebel. Oh, are they coming back? Oh man. This'll be close. Oh my gosh. Hey, they did it. Huh. I guess I just have a higher DPS. This poor guy got splashed out into the middle of nowhere. I'll go report that in the Discord. Since that's hilarious. Let's copy that image. Alright. I don't want to save it. But that'll be all for now. I love playing the Fire Ant update. We'll eventually have to do a free play mode with the Fire Ant stuff, because that'll be incredibly fun. But thanks to everyone that showed up.